For nearly 100 years, the pap smear has been used by the medical community for cervical cancer screening. But now, a newly FDA-approved HPV test is causing great debate in the medical community. I'm Dr. Sangini Sheth, and this is my expert opinion. So the new test is primary HPV screening that has been approved by the FDA. There are a few different professional societies that provide guidelines in terms of cervical cancer screening. The professional societies themselves have not incorporated primary HPV testing into their formal guidelines. The process that a female patient would have to go through essentially doesn't change. It still involves a gynecologic exam, and really it's the result that changes. The information that the patient and the physician or provider would receive is whether there is high-risk HPV present. So the controversy stems around what role this testing has right now, and if we have enough information and evidence to begin using this test. The pros to using this test are that the studies that have been done to this point show that using HPV testing alone is just as good, if not better, than using a pap smear. The controversial side is what are we going to do with women who test positive? HPV is very common in women, especially young women, and most of them their bodies are able to clear it on its own. So will having positive results trigger a whole series of tests and procedures that may be unnecessary? I don't think it's ready to be incorporated into routine clinical practice right now. I think it's a very exciting point in time in terms of cervical cancer screening, and I think that it may have great utility in the near future, but there are studies going on right now, and I think that until the professional organizations that I mentioned come out with more formal guidelines so that all providers of women's healthcare can practice in the same way, I think it's still early to be incorporating into routine clinical practice.